अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. आई एम फाइन टू अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह. वेलकम टू मैथ्स गुरु. आई एम योर होस्ट FTG, एज यूजुअल बिजी इन प्रिपेयरिंग वीडियोज़ फॉर यू गाइस. एंड आई होप यू ऑल विल बी एंजॉइंग योर समर वेकेशंस एंड यू ऑल विल बी प्रेइंग अलॉट सिंस रमज़ान मुबारक इज़ गोइंग ऑन एंड यू ऑल विल बी एंजॉइंग द डिलीशियस कुजींस ऑफ रमज़ान. मे अल्लाह ब्लेस अस ऑल and may Allah accept our fast and our good deeds. Ameen. Just want to remind you about the coronavirus, that this pandemic is increasing rapidly, and you all should be very careful and you all should pray for all of us. May Allah protect us from this virus. So starting with today's topic, and in the previous topics I told you that we will be doing some more worksheets on Venn diagrams. So we have drawn some Venn diagrams in the previous questions, and I solved some questions from book D2. And after drawing Venn diagrams, the next important thing is to shade the Venn diagrams. This worksheet will give you an idea of how to shade the Venn diagrams. This worksheet is basically a very basic level worksheet. Since this topic is very confusing and there are no certain tricks for shading, so that's why I'm starting this from a very basic level. This worksheet is basically a very basic level, and in this worksheet we have 6 questions, and in each question we are asked to shade a certain operator. For example, in part 1 we have to shade the region that belongs to A union B. In the second part, we have to shade the region that has A intersection B. In the third part, we have to shade the region of B minus A. In the fourth part, we have to shade the region of B. And in the fifth part, we have to shade the region of A minus B. And in the last part, we have to shade the region A. So first of all, I will be starting with the fourth and the sixth part, because these two parts are very much easy. And since we have to shade the set B, so I have to shade the complete set B. So I will just shade it like this. Since I don't have colors right now, so I will just shade it like this, so that you can see that I am highlighting or prominating this area. And this is the required region, since it is saying that you have to shade B. So it's just simple. I have to shade the set B. I told you that in Venn diagram the sets are represented by circles. So A and B are our sets, and we just have to shade B. So this is our B, and I have shaded it. And in the sixth part, I just have to shade A. So I will just shade it like this properly. And this Venn diagram is a very easy topic and a very confusing topic too, because there are no certain tricks for that. You just have to use your imagination and you just have to use your concepts to shade it. I tried to solve some questions in the previous video, in which we mathematically find out A minus B, B minus A, A union B, intersection B. In this worksheet, we will be finding out the answers by shading. We don't have to write the numbers on the sets, because we don't have any numbers. We just have to shade the region to tell that the answer will be included in this region. So these two questions were the simplest one, so I started with them. In the fourth one, I just have to shade the B set, so I just shaded the B part. And in the sixth part, I just have to shade the A part, so I just shaded it. So these two are very simple. So now we will be starting with the first question. The first question is, I have to shade the part of A union B. In order to shade A union B, I just want you to revise what does this union operator tells us. This union operator tells us that we have to combine both A and B. Means we have to shade both A and B. Union means we have to shade both A and B. This means when I will shade this A and B, this whole diagram will get shaded. So union means I have to shade both the sets. Union means combination, and we know that we have to combine that in such a way that no one should be left out and no member should be repeated. So in order to understand this shading, you just have to memorize that union means both. You have to shade both parts. You have to shade the combination of both the parts. So this is basically the answer of the first part, that is, we have shaded the A union B part. For the second part, the question says that you have to shade A intersection B, and we know that intersection means common. So union means you have to shade the combine, we have to shade both of them, but intersection means common. So since this part is the common part between A and B, so I will shade this part. I will not be shading the whole A and B because this is not union, this is basically intersection. So I will just shade this common part. This is basically the intersection part. The third part is the difference operator, and we know that B minus A means, if I want to describe this in words, means all the elements of B that are not in A. This is the same trick which we use when we were solving it mathematically. We solved the a question on B minus A and A minus B. I told you that A minus B and B minus A is not equal. If you guys haven't seen that video, so you must see that video. I just solved some questions on this operations on sets, so you must see that video, and then you should come on the shading part. So B minus A means we have to find those elements that are not that are in B, not in A. So means I have to shade only those part of B that have no connection with A. Means I have to find those elements of B that are not in A. Or in other words, you can do it simply. Shade the whole part B and then remove A from it, and then remove the part which is connecting that has a connection with A. So B minus A means just shade the whole B and then remove this part, because this part is common with the A part. So I will just be shading this part only, because if you want to express this in word, B minus A means I have to find those elements that are a part of B but that are not in A. Means only the elements of B that are not in A. So this will be the part that has only the elements of B that has no connection with the set A. So I will just be shading the part of B which has no connection with A. In simple words, you can say that you have to shade that part of B that has no connection with A. So this is the part that represents B minus A. And the last question is A minus B means I have to find those elements of A that has no connection with B. Means I have to shade this part only. So these two connections, these two questions were very much related. And I told you in my previous video how to find this A minus B and B minus A union, intersection and difference mathematically. And in this video you are also seeing how we can shade this part. And I told you in that video that we can also find the answer by the Venn diagram. If you want to find out A union B, you can also find it through Venn diagram. So this is that part in which we were asked to shade a region, and there are no values of sets given, there are no numbers given. We just have to shade the region in order to express our answer, and you have to express your answer by shading A union B. The answer will lie in this shaded region. A intersection B means the common part only. Set B means I have to shade the B only. Set A means I have to shade the A only. B minus A means those members of B that has no connection with A. A minus B means those members of A that has no connection with B. So that was a worksheet on shading of Venn diagrams. It's a very basic worksheet because this topic is a bit confusing. So I started with a starter. This starter is just a basic level. We'll be solving some more worksheets that will be advanced level. And I hope you are pretty much sure and you have revised this concept. Just try it one more time by drawing these figures and then shading it. And stay tuned to Maths Guru for some more videos on shading of Venn diagrams.